Hello, faith leaders, and welcome to Break Time. Today we are in Psalm 10:2. In his arrogance, the wicked man hunts down the weak who are caught in the schemes he devises. You know what this sounds like to me? It sounds like bullying, doesn't it? Because the arrogant, those are the people that David was describing as, and he's going to give a ton of description of what arrogant and prideful people look like. But one of the things that we need to remember about the arrogant is that they are terribly insecure people, to the place where they go after the weak and use them as their pawns in their scheme, or they use them to make themselves feel better, or they use them as, you know, a rung in a ladder to get where they need to go. They're famous for using people because they can't do it on their own. So they have to use those that are actually stronger, I would say. But bullying happens all the time inside the workplace. You know, you have people who are prideful, who are arrogant, who think that they're better than other people. And they prey off of looking for whom they think is weak to divide, to use in their scheming matters. And workplace bullying goes along, you know, they can make fun of you, they can, you know, whatever it is, whatever scheme that they're up to. Remember that the premise behind it is so that they can feel better about themselves, you know, and it feels awful to be bullied. It feels awful to think that people that think that they're better want to use somebody to make themselves either feel more secure, more powerful, greater position of status, whatever it may be. But I think the most important thing to, if you're in that situation, in a workplace bullying situation, where you're feeling used, you're feeling like a pawn, you're being made fun of, maybe people are talking behind your back, maybe they're saying things, maybe they're planning schemes just to plot against you. Remember this, their mind is not set in a good place. And they are there. They're using you to help them achieve even a better place, making themselves feel better. But remember, they're typically awfully, they do not have a good feeling or a good sense about who they are. And so when they see somebody that's typically stronger, that's typically can do better work than they can, or typically smarter, or, you know, the list can go on and on and on and on. That's their prey. They see them as, you know, that's that they see them. They see if you're being bullied, they'll see you as somebody almost to be intimidated by. But instead of doing that, they prey on you. And often they go after those who are very compassionate, very loving, very kind. And so if that's you, know that there's such a thing called boundaries. You don't have to receive. You can take a stand. It's okay to do that. It's not an ungodly thing. But David was praying to God to say, God, can you see their plan? Can you see what they're doing? Are you aware of what's going on here? Because he almost felt forgotten by God because, you know, he was being chased at one time by a bully, workplace bully. He was actually a workplace bully. And so you almost forgotten by God, because you're thinking, why is this happening to me? Remember, God has not forgotten you. But why spend some time lifting the person up that may be bullying you in prayer? Ask God to give you a perspective, their perspective. And, you know, kill them with kindness. I know that might sound like a cliche, but it's very spirit. It's very scriptural. You're going to need the power of the Spirit to do it. You know, kindness puts out so many fires. It's the water that goes on the flame that it can't withstand it. You know, the thing a bully wants to do is intimidate you or squash you or make you part of their scheme. Instead of playing the pawn, kill them with kindness. Try it. See what happens. Because in passages of scripture, that's what it, I mean, those are truths that we can grip, that we can take a hold of. And you, my friend, have a blessed day.